Get 3 months of local news for just 99 cents a month. You'll get unlimited access to the news you need to stay engaged and connected to your community. Visit DuluthNewsTribune.com/subscribe now to get 3 months of local news for only 99 cents a month.
Hello, Northlanders. It's Wednesday, January 4th. I'm Wyatt Buckner with the Duluth News Tribune Minute, presented by Minnesota Power Employees Credit Union.
The average MPECU member saves over $785 a year in better rates and lower fees. And with MPECU, every ATM is your ATM. With their free checking program, you get ATM fee reimbursements at any ATM, anywhere in the U.S. Check out Minnesota Power Employees Credit Union services online at mpecu.com or visit their offices in downtown Duluth, Arrowhead Road, or Miller Trunk Highway.
Now, here's a look at today's headlines. Cirrus Aircraft's leadership team says the company is stretched, trying to keep pace with the demand for its airplanes. CEO Zine Nielsen said everything the company can produce in the next 2 years is already sold. Cirrus currently has orders for more than 1,000 piston-engine airplanes and more than 300 jets. Its present rate of production is about 10 piston-engine and 2 jet engine planes per week. Nielsen said Cirrus has been working hard to reduce customer wait times, hiring more than 450 people in the past year, largely to fill production jobs in Duluth, where the company now employs more than 1,200 people. Recently, Cirrus added a second production shift in Duluth. Through the first 9 months of 2022, Cirrus delivered 366 airplanes with a combined sales totaling nearly $440 million, according to a report by the General Aviation Manufacturers Association. Sales were trending 15% higher than in 2021. Nielsen explained that the pandemic has enabled more people to work remotely, and not being tied to the office has provided them with more flexibility to pursue a pilot's license. Cirrus's headquarters remained firmly rooted in Duluth, where the company recently doubled down by purchasing a former aircraft maintenance, repair, and overhaul facility, and it's now investing north of $7 million to transform the 189,000-square-foot building into an R&D facility that Cirrus has dubbed its, quote, Innovation Center of Excellence, end quote. But Nielsen said the city's stagnant population, housing shortage, and daycare needs remain a concern. Cirrus continues to work with city leaders and other businesses to help grow Duluth's population. Minnesota lawmakers on Tuesday returned to a very different climate at the Capitol as they gaveled in the 2023 legislative session. Democrats have complete control of state government for the first time since 2014, only the second time in more than 30 years. That means they'll be able to pursue plans to increase funding for education, create a paid family and medical leave program, and codify abortion protections into law without having to make major compromises with Republicans. The legislature has to get an over $50 billion state budget together for the next 2 years, as the current biennial budget ends June 30th. State government runs out of funding and shuts down if the governor doesn't sign budget bills into law by that date. There's a historic $17.6 billion projected budget surplus over which Governor Tim Walz and Democratic farmer-labor majorities in the Senate and House will have control over how it's spent. During his second inaugural address on Monday, Walz vowed to put education, children, and families at the center of his budget proposal. While the legislature will be in session until May, lawmakers, activists, and interest groups have already hit the ground running with abortion rights and marijuana legalization. The House Health Committee is scheduled Thursday to hold a hearing on a bill to protect abortion rights called the Protect Reproductive Options Act, or PRO Act. House leadership has expressed a strong commitment to codifying abortion rights in state law, and with complete Democratic Party control of state government, the odds of such a bill making it to the governor's desk appear higher than ever. Before the House and Senate reconvened at noon Tuesday, groups for and against the legalization of recreational marijuana held news conferences to state their cases. The Minnesota Department of Natural Resources has begun pumping water out of the Canisteo mine pit to reduce the water level and delay the water from overtopping the mine and spilling into this nearby city. The pumps will move up to 11,000 gallons of water per minute from the Canisteo pit into a nearby wetland that flows into Holman Lake, creating unsafe ice conditions on all three bodies of water. Anglers, snowmobilers, and others are urged to stay off all three bodies of water this winter. The pumping is part of an ongoing effort to keep groundwater that's rising in the abandoned mine pit from spilling into Bovee. The effort was put on hold in September when zebra mussels were discovered in the mine pit water. The pump system is funded with money from the State Office of Iron Range Resources and Rehabilitation, but is only temporary, as Iron Range lawmakers try to seek a larger source of permanent funding from the 2023 legislature. Mining at the Canisteo pit stopped in 1980, and there is no responsible company remaining to tap to pay for the pumping project. Now here's a look at your forecast, brought to you by the Women Today 6th Annual Rosie Awards.
Happy snowy Wednesday, Duluth. We are looking at temperatures relatively steady in the upper 20s throughout the day today. Winds from the northeast, 15 to 25 miles an hour, so a very wet, sticky snow expected. Another 1 to 3 inches expected during the day today. Could see an additional inch overnight tonight of that snow eventually tapers off. As we head into your Thursday, temperatures will be colder with a high around 22 degrees in the afternoon with partly cloudy skies. For Friday, 18 with partly cloudy, more sunshine and temperatures back around 20 by Saturday. I'm Storm Tracker meteorologist Jesse Ritka.
Thank you to the Rosie Awards for their support. Northland women are a driving force in our community. They are advocates, mentors, volunteers, and leaders. Nominate a special woman you think deserves to be recognized at thewomantoday.com or by email at dearrosie@thewomantoday.com. Nominations are now open and continue through January 31st. Reporting for today's episode was done by Peter Passy, Alex DeRozier, and John Myers. Thank you for listening to the Duluth News Tribune Minute. Have a great day, and we'll see you back here tomorrow.